Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. Today's video is actually a super fun video, lots of work, but I think you're gonna enjoy it. I am going to redo slash do a makeover to Honey's bedroom. So this is what we are starting with. There's just a ton of stuff just thrown inside of there. And
that's the brush right here, yes.
Yes, so.
This is from the baby.
Oh yeah, that's for the baby, yeah, but you could use that to brush your hair too. Yeah, so she's in there trying to find all her fun stuff. So we are going to just do a clean out, a really deep clean, and get rid of stuff that we don't need. And then the stuff that she just got for her birthday and all that are going to get packed away really nicely in there. There are some things that I don't think I have as yet, but I think once I start packing stuff out and you know, trying to see where I'm going to place everything, then things are going to start to fall into place. And then I will share whatever I got with you, where I found it. And yeah, so without any further ado, let's get to deep cleaning and decorating. Today's also, by the way, today's also laundry. Today's also a Sunday, so I have like a bunch of other things happening. I have laundry happening over here, and I don't know, it's just crazy, but come along for the ride. All right, let's get to this situation here.
It's tangled.
Oh, okay, we'll help her just now. All right, so
I'm brushing here with this brush.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Right, so this is just, this needs to go. This is all my books and Adam's books, and then we will just start. I don't even know. I don't know what I'm showing you guys. I'm just, this is our starting point, pretty much. All right. I just realized I had intentions of doing a winner's haul video, but there's no way I could do that right now and do this video at the same time without, I don't know. Maybe I can, maybe I can't. But if I can't, I want to take a moment to show you what I got at winners. So okay, so because what happens is I have to wash these things to use these things for her bedroom, right? So I got this. Actually, I think I need to flip the camera. Okay, just a sec. Okay, so this is the bedroom set that I got for her, and I got this at winners. So this was $60. You get two decorative pillows, you get the comforter, and you get this. Yeah, so this pillow is this one here, this pink one is this one here, and then you get the comforter. It's four pieces, and then you get a pillow cover. So that's what it looks like there with some little ballerinas. Absolutely love it. And so her bedroom theme is kind of like ballerinas, mermaids meets unicorns slash. Now, when I was in Winners, I tried multiple times. Let me see if I zoom out, if that will work for you. I tried to get the sheets for this pattern so that we could have used it, but for some reason they did not, oops, sorry. For some reason they didn't have these ballerinas. So what I did is I picked up these mermaids. They're somewhat in the same color scheme, right? So I picked up these mermaids to have a sheet, and I had also gotten a sheet like a long time before, thinking of even doing this, and I will show you that as well. But that one I think is folded in the closet, so we'll have to go look for that one. So I have two interchangeable sheets, so like when this one's washing I have another one, and when that one's washing I have this one, so we could interchange it. And then as I said, it'll just be a mashup of ballerina meets mermaid meets unicorn. And so what I did find that I liked, this bag also, I bought this bag, isn't it cute, and has like little yoga poses on it. It is so cool, love it. And the colors just go, oh, just love it. Okay, so I got this super 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 soft. This is like a throw, like a faux fur throw. It is so soft. Like, I wish you could feel it, or don't know if you could see it through the video, but it's so soft. And then it has this inside. So I think secretly I might have bought this for myself. But anyways, no, it is really nice. And when I saw it, like, I kind of was like, ooh, this is gonna go. Because the same colors, right? And then to top it off, to put on top the bed, I found these little girls. So I have one ballerina, one mermaid. Do you see? Like, everything just kind of fell into place. It's so cool. So, like, these were $12.99 each. So I have to wash these girls. I have to wash this. I have to wash this. I have to wash that and get that ready. So those, I'll put those to wash while I clean out the bedroom. And that's it for now in terms of the winner's haul. Oh, there is a like a picture that I got to put in her room. So I have, but that's all the way downstairs. So when I bring that up, I'll show you. If there's anything else, I'll show you in the video while I find it or come across it. But I think this was the bulk of it. It was the bedding, the extra sheets, the two grills to go on top of the bed, or like if I get a shelf or anything. And then this this faux throw. So okay, time to go cleaning now. Started by just clearing everything out, and while I cleared everything out, I made different piles. So there were piles of her gifts and everything that needed to come back in the room. There were piles that of stuff that had to go into different rooms or different spaces that didn't belong in here. And I also made a pile for giveaway. It was a great chance to, you know, declutter and clear out and purge. I then started sweeping and getting all under the bed, all behind the bed, all behind the dresser, and just started my deep clean process.
Yesterday, there was sun and there was rain. Beauty in the mountain.
So then I went on to cleaning the windows. I pulled up the blinds as far as they could go, and I just started dusting and cleaning all the moldings, the window trim, the baseboards, everything. So much dust collects here if we don't clean it off on a regular basis, but it's just crazy. So I basically used some Lysol wipes and I cleaned all around the side, and then I used some paper towel and Windex to clean the windows, and I just did a very, very thorough clean of everything so that it was dust free. Now it's time to clear out this bookshelf. As you can see, a lot more than books have been collecting in this bookshelf. The back is also coming out of this bookshelf, and that is going to be something I have to tackle. I am making piles for Honey's books, what is going to go back on this bookshelf, and then everything else is going to go to their respective places. A lot of my books, a lot of Adam's books, and Somerset's as well. All right, so this bookshelf, this had popped out. So for a long time we kind of weren't using it. So what I can't remember why we did what we did, how we built, how we stuck this down, because they only have two nails. We would have usually done three, and I'm seeing that this didn't go up in here. So what I'm gonna do, and I'm seeing that we taped the back here, so I'm not sure if it was like a sizing issue that we had. I don't know. It's been so long since we built this. So what I'm going to do is try to be able to utilize this, because I don't want the bookshelf without the back. But if I have to use it without the back, I will. But I'm going to try to save it. So I'm going to take these out. I'm going to try to slide this up here and then retape it if I need for extra support. And nail it back down again a couple more times. I think what it was... No, that doesn't make sense. All right. It looks like it might have been too long. Because that side is in there. But this side isn't. I don't know. Anyways, that's what I'm going to try and figure out now. Figure out how to do this. Then, once I'm done that, I could wipe down everything, fix the bookshelf, pack it back up, and then get all the books in, take this bad boy off, wash it, and make up the bed, and then we're doing good. Going good. It's going along nice. Beyond gravel, beyond dawn. A bigger scale, the world inhales. So I struggled with this thing. Like, it just refused to go inside. It kept slipping out. I tried it a bunch of different ways. And then I decided to call Seth up to see if he could help me and have a set of extra hands to see if we could get it in. So I'm trying to get it into a groove. There's a groove here.
Yeah.
And here.
Yeah.
And in front here. And it keeps slipping out. So I'm going to try to hold it. Could you put your hand on this side right here so we can try to get it in this group, but on that side?
Yep.
Like, we just have to put our hands together gently. Like, you don't push too hard, I'll tell you. That's too hard. You're pushing too hard. I'm just trying to get it in there. You have to look too. You can look on your side. You can see if it's going in or not.
Okay.
Like,
it's not in.
I know. Hold on. Maybe if we turn it this way. Hold on. Raise up a second. Because I can't get it to work any other way.
Okay, is it yes in?
It's in that way?
Yep, it's in on top.
Okay, so now we need to hold it in place so I could,
So do I put
it? Is it slipping?
No.
It was just moving. I need to hammer it in place.
Okay, so
so which? That it does not fall. Do you want to help me do that?
Yes, so
see how it's like... It's on the side how it's... Alright, so update on the sheets. As I was putting it to wash, I realized, I'll show you, hold on a second, sorry. Okay, so when I took the sheets out, I love, like, the pattern is still a really nice pattern. The mermaids are so, so cute. Little bubbles, little fish. But I'm not 100% in love with the feel of it. And what I realized is that I thought it was 100% cotton, and it's only after I opened it and felt it, it's actually 100% cotton sateen. And that's a huge difference. It feels very different to her other sheet. So her other sheet, actually, I took it out to compare, is this one right here. This one. This is 100% cotton, and it feels softer, nicer. I like it. This sateen thing, it has like a, I don't even know how to explain it. It's like, it's not soft. It's almost like a shimmery feel. Does that even make any sense? Like a shimmery feel. Like it just, like it's not, it's kind of soft, but in a different way. It's soft in a very, I don't know. So I am yet to figure out if I'm going to keep it or if I'm going to return it and try to find some other alternative, because I do have a couple more days before I have left to return. So what I'm going to do is use her other sheet that I had and make up her bed with that and then figure out this. Do you know, like, do you use sateen sheets? Do you like the feeling of cotton sateen as opposed to regular cotton? Like, I actually didn't realize that was a thing until I felt it. And this is what happens sometimes. So next time you're buying sheets, look to make sure it says cotton or cotton sateen behind it, because it makes a difference. Now, I don't know. My problem is that I don't know if it's going to soften when it washes. And like, I prefer that it's soft, not just, I really wish I could explain how this feels. Like, I have no idea how to explain how it feels. I even actually asked her, like, if she prefers this over that. Like, she didn't seem to like it too much. So when I figure out what I'm gonna do, I'll let you guys know. But as of right now, I'm not 100% in love. Who knows, in the next couple hours I might turn around, but then I'll figure out. So I'm just gonna finish up what I have. I'm gonna use finish up in there. I'm just waiting for the room to dry because I just mopped it. I am going to use the old sheet that I have, and then when I figure out what I'm gonna do with this one, I'll let you know. Okay, back to cleaning. Do you want your bed this way, or do you want your bed against the wall like what it used to be?
I want my bed like this.
What does this mean?
This well, that's like the wall.
So do you want to sleep like this, or do you want to put the bed back against the wall? Remember how it used to be? It used to be like this, and then you have all this space in the middle to play. Do you want it like that again, or do you want it like this?
I want it like, I just want it, what did you just say?
Do you want your bed like this, and the bookshelf there? Or do you want me to take the bed and put it here? Remember how it used to be against this wall? Remember how the bed used to be this way? Do you remember that?
No,
okay, no, let me show you. Okay, so we are going really well, but I figured what I'm gonna do, as you can tell, Lexi's getting a little cranky and she has to go. I'm pretty sure she's gonna nap today, but we'll see. But I am gonna finish up everything. I have a bunch of stuff still to pack away. Like, I want to pack away the books on the bookshelf and all that stuff, and get the bed made up and everything. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do like a reveal. So instead of you seeing me put everything away and up and down, because I don't know, if I think it might be more fun if it is that you got to see the deep clean part, which I'm done with now. I mopped out, I mopped twice, and now it's just to put all the finishing touches on. I think you would like the the reveal of that. So I am going to close the door now and I will let you see the finished process once I'm done. Okay? Bye. Hey guys, I'm finished and it looks so good. I'm super happy with how it came out. I do think though I'm gonna have to do a part two because there are some things that I need still to get to put here and there, but right now it is so cute, so nice. I'm gonna show you a sneak peek quickly before I bring her up and show her. So this is her bed and her little stuffy collection over here. And this is actually supposed to be her dirty clothes hamper. So I have to see if I'm gonna tuck that away or put a new washroom. Not sure where I'm gonna put that yet. And then these are the little girls right here. I need two pillows. This is super soft. But what I ended up doing with these sheets, I ended up keeping this one and I'm returning the other one for sure. I have a backup idea for what I'm gonna do for the other one. I'll show you that just now. But so this is something she got for her birthday that she's been dying to open. So I just put it here. So this is a pony that you brush her hair and you can use these little clips and ponytails to put in. This is a Snoopy that she chose. So this is our fall, one of our fall decorations for this year. So she chose this little Snoopy guy. So I put it in her room because Seth chose something else for his room. So that's the start of our fall decor right there. This is my mom's lamp. And the reason I kept it in here is because we don't have a lamp for right now. So in the night, it's nice to have. And this one is kind of has two tone. It goes this, it goes like one, two, and then you could do either one or you could do both. And we need a lamp for right now, so I put that there. Now she doesn't necessarily need a side table, but what I did with the side table is I kept it so that we could use in here as storage for now. And her little Fisher Price playset. I put a few books, and then what I would do is I would rotate her books as she uses them. She built this this summer. She built this all on her own and I was so impressed. We have another one to build and we'll put it up. And then we have some more books up here. This is a sign that I actually forgot that I had and I remembered it on Sunday while I was looking through a drawer. I found it and I was thinking of sticking it up on top the wall, but I haven't decided what I'm gonna put on the wall as yet because I'm thinking of putting some pictures of her and us or something like that in here. So I just have it in her bookshelf for right now, just so that it's there. And then some of the books that she got for her birthday from friends and family. Then this was with this, I had it packed away. So I had gotten this at a farm a couple of years ago and I loved it. So now I just need to print a picture of her and put inside of there. Actually, I know the exact picture. It was when she was 1 year old. She was a mermaid. So I will get that printed for her. Then this was from her grandparents, Adam's parents. This is actually the day Lexi came home. This was her from the hospital. Her socks were too big. Her clothes were too big. That outfit Seth chose for her. Oh my gosh, I cannot believe she's 4 already. Where has the time gone? This she got from one of her friends last year. This piggy bank, or unicorn bank. I don't know if I don't know what to call it. But this was also a winner's find. Well, winner's home sense find. It is so cute. It has a little tutu on it and it's a piggy bank. And she's been really, really wanting to have her own. Even though I have one packed away for her, she really has wanted her own to start putting her money inside because she sees her big brother do it. And then I just took her calendar that she has. We got her a little one last year and this is a frozen calendar, so I've been showing her how to cross off the dates. We started it last year for her birthday. And then a few of her toys right here. And this sign also came from HomeSense and I found it was just so cute. Yes, it's pink, but I just love the sign. I loved what it said. I liked that they had a rainbow and it wasn't too pink, you know what I mean? Like, it's more peach on this side and then just sparkly pink. A little sparkle, why not? Then this was actually a sign that one of my friends from work had bought for Lexi. She saw it and she's like, oh my gosh, I just thought of Honey and I just had to buy it for her. And so thank you, Auntie Dana. And yeah, so that's it. It came out so nice and I'm just waiting. So again, as I said, I will probably do a part two because like I want to do something on the wall here for her. I think I want to do, let me just make it a little bit. I want to do a little something here as well. Not quite sure yet, but I want to do something there. And I do want to get a mat for hair for her. So I turned the bed this way. The room used to have the bed this way before when my mom was here. And I did find they have a lot more space, especially for, you know, if she's going to be up here playing on her own and doing her own thing. I want to get a little mat for her. I haven't decided if I'm going to do like a round mat for in the center or a rectangular mat for next to the bed. I haven't decided as yet. I just don't want to buy something just for buying something's sake. I want to buy something because it's like, oh, that's perfect for Honey, which is kind of like how some of these things came along. Like the unicorn bank was like something I had seen and I was like, oh my gosh, that's so cute. The sign, Auntie Dana who bought that for her, and things that we had bought from before, and it just kind of all fell into place. The lamp, like I'm keeping my mom's lamp for now. No, it doesn't match with the room, but I looked for lamps on Amazon. I looked for lamps in HomeSense and Winners. I looked for lamps everywhere and I do not like what I saw. Like, they are just not right. They're not right. And I'm not gonna just buy something just because I want it to match the theme. I'm gonna wait until it finds us. So that's that. Oh, and underneath here actually has two drawers under this bed. So this is an IKEA bed, a mom. And in here has some other stuff. So it's very neatly packed away. Some extra toys that she got for her birthday, counting stuff, just a lot of different things. And what I would do is I would just cycle through all her toys and stuff so that she doesn't have everything out all at once and she could focus on what it is she has out. And then we'll take out, we'll pack away, and we'll bring out. And we'll just do like a toy rotation. So yeah, I am so happy with how it came out. Let me go call her up so she could get to see what it looks like. Okay, so I'm hiding and Seth is bringing her up. Yeah. You like it? Welcome to your room.
This one, did she get that?
Huh? Aha, that's when we went. Remember when we went? You like it, Lexi?
Yeah.
Okay, so you have to open the clip. So you open it, you see how it's closed there? You have to open it, pull it open, and then we can close it.
I'm gonna brush her hair.
Yeah, look, you see, it's open.
Okay.
Yeah, so you hold, put a little bit of her hair and then put it through. Wait, open it, wait, open it. Okay, put it through, and then close it. Good. There you go. Ta-da!
Like a toy, like Maya.
You like it?
Yeah. I'm gonna put another one too.
Another clip? Yeah, sure, hold on. Look, Lexi. You like it? It's soft, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's so soft.
I like it. Why you told me this?
Huh?
Why you told me this?
Why I told you? What do you mean?
I like this bed.
You like it?
Yeah.
I'm so happy you like it. Now you have your own space to be in. All right, you guys, she loves it, right, Lexi?
Yeah.
She loves it. I forgot to show you this because this was actually on the bed and then I had put the comforter on. So this is underneath. So this is super soft and fuzzy. It washed really well. I love it. She
Mommy.
And then it's soft on the inside as well. So that was nice, right? Yeah.
The tinder fell down and I hit the noise.
You hear the noise?
Yeah.
So are you gonna sleep in your
that noise?
Are you gonna sleep in your bedroom tonight?
Yeah.
It's so nice. What are you looking at? Oh, you like it? Thank you. Thank you. Oh gosh, Lexi. Thank you so much. You can take a picture with Mama?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, first, let's just say goodbye to everyone, okay? And then we take a picture.
Goodbye.
So we say, thank you so much. All right, you guys, that is it. Thank you so much for watching along. This was such a fun project to do. Yes, it was a lot of work, but her reaction and just seeing how it came out so nice. It's so warm and cozy. Yay! And she's super duper excited with it. It's really good what I did there, because then she has a little surface to play on, so that's pretty epic there. So I will definitely keep you posted on if I do any changes. Of course, it's going to be a constant work in progress as we progress and she uses the space and I see how she uses the space. But I'll definitely be up for doing a part two to this video at some point in time. I think now is such a perfect That was such a perfect time to have done this project, because you know she's four now, it's fall, it's a transition month, and what a great time for her to transition into her own space for herself. Anyways, thank you so much. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any comments or questions, please leave it in the comment box below and I'll definitely check them out. And don't forget to subscribe, because I have lots more videos coming up. Oh yes, her belly button is outside. How rude. Oh, so cute. She's a mermaid and the other one is a ballerina, so we have to find names for them. All right, you guys, so subscribe, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. Notification bell is so that when I post new videos or upload new videos, you would get a notification saying that I uploaded a new video. Oh my gosh, so cute. But yes, I will be recording lots more videos and I will see you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Hmm.